Hey everyone, this is Android Cemetery, and in this video I'm going to be taking a look back at all of my previous work in the last year, and I'm also going to be talking about a few ways that I improved my 3D portfolio in the last year, and hopefully these tips and tricks will help you in your 3D art journey. So the first way that I improved my art was by trying to force myself to get out of my comfort zone. If you check some of my old work on Instagram and YouTube, you can see most of my art is very simple and basic. And my biggest problem when first starting out was I was afraid to make more complex models because I didn't want to screw it up. It was after about 2 months of making simple models that I finally decided I would try and make more complex models, and I found my skills improving a lot faster. Then, around mid-year, I finally decided to model something that I've wanted to model for a long time. Kronk from the Ratchet & Clank series. Honestly, modeling this was really daunting because I've never created something this detailed before. This model took me a lot longer to make than I thought it would. But by the end, I was really happy with the way it turned out. And I am hoping to create some more larger projects like this in the future. Doing more complex texture work. A lot of my previous work has really basic textures. I would usually just add a material and then call it a day. It was only until I started looking at proper reference photos and considering the story behind the 3D art that my texture work really started to improve. The best example of this is probably a comparison between two Pokeball models that I've created. One of them has extremely basic plastic and metal materials applied to them, with not much else in terms of varying roughness details, and my other, most recent one has a lot more intricate materials and details. I really took into consideration the materials and the story behind the model. So for example, a Pokeball is usually thrown in grassy areas, and because this ancient Pokeball is partially created out of wood, I thought it'd be interesting for the bottom to have grass stains and moss growing out. There's also a lot of scratches and dents in the Pokeball itself because of the fact that it's thrown around all the time. So I think the first thing you need to consider when texturing is the story behind the model. Think about how the model will be used in real life, and definitely check out a lot of reference images. Focus on one thing at a time. There are many exciting aspects of creating 3D art. Character modeling, environment modeling, particle effects, cloth physics, the list goes on. And trying to learn all of these different aspects of 3D at the same time will only make things more confusing, and you'll just be spreading yourself too thin. This is definitely the problem that I first had getting into Blender. I really just wanted to learn every aspect of Blender, and in the end, I learned none of it. After that, I started to focus on making simple props from start to finish. I would usually create one or two models a week. I would do modeling, texturing, and then the final render. Each week, I would focus on these three aspects of the modeling process. And then after I got really good at modeling, I started to learn sculpting. And it was much easier to focus on learning one thing at a time rather than trying to overload my brain with all of this different information. So learn one thing, practice it until you get really good, then try and learn something else. Making art that you want to make. Along with a lot of my previous work being really basic, a lot of it is also just random objects that I have around my house. Like for example, this soda can, and also these computer speakers. And this bench was just a bench that I saw when I was doing my shopping. And although it was easier to make these kinds of models because I had the references right in front of me, it wasn't something that really kept me motivated to make more art. So later on, I started to do more fan art for movies, TV shows, anime, and video games that I personally enjoy. Like for example, Pokemon, Dragon Ball Z, Kingdom Hearts, and Ratchet & Clank. And these are the art pieces that I'm definitely most proud of and really helped me stay motivated to work more and improve my skills. And out of all of my work, the fan art is definitely the most enjoyable to do. And recreating art from properties that you enjoy is always really rewarding. So it's important to create the kind of artwork that you enjoy making, because staying motivated to continue working is extremely important. So I hope you enjoy the video. If you're a beginner 3D artist, I hope you found some of this information useful. I'm also hoping that some of this advice will help you out in your own 3D journeys. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.